5 times sin A plus cos A is 7 and 25 times sin A into cos A is 12. Then find the value of 5 sin A plus 10 cos A. So they gave us 5 times sin A plus cos A is equals to 7. That implies sin A plus cos A will be equals to 7 by 5. Right, and here they gave us 25 times of sin A into cos A is equals to 12. That implies we can say sin A into cos A is equals to 12 divided by 25. So we know sin A plus cos A and we know sin A into cos A. So we need to identify first sin A cos A value, then only we'll be able to identify this particular answer for us. So how do we do? So one thing what we can do is you can apply this particular thing, which is sin A minus cos A. If I know, I'll be able to identify these values. So I can't directly find sin A minus cos A. So what am I going to do? First, I'm going to identify the square, sin A minus cos A square. So sin A minus cos A square you can take, or you can even take cos A minus sin A square also. Sin A square also. So what happened if we expand it? This is nothing but A minus B whole square. So A square plus B square minus 2AB, which is nothing but 2 into sin A cos A. Here also the same thing will come. A square is nothing but cos here. Cos square A plus sin square A minus 2 into sin A cos A. Right? So now what is sin square A plus cos square A? It's nothing but 1. Sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1. So here what will happen? 1 minus 2 into sin A into cos A is how much? We already know here, which is 12 divided by 25. So this is going to give us the answer as 1 minus 24 by 25, which is 1 divided by 25. So sin A minus cos A whole square is 1 divided by 25. That implies we can say sin A minus cos A value will be equals to 1 by 5, because the square comes this side, it will become root. And similarly, here also, this is 1 minus 2 into 12 divided by 25, which is nothing but again 1 by 25. So here again, I'll get cos A minus sin A will be equals to 1 by 5 itself. Actually, sin A minus cos A or cos A minus sin A will be same. Okay, so this both will be same. Now I can use any of this expression. That's why I will get two answers here. So let's try to solve. So we already know sin A plus cos A is equals to 7 by 5. That means if I take here sin A plus cos A is equals to 7 by 5. So let me perform the same operation. So this will get cancelled and we will get 2 into sin A will be equals to 8 by 5. That implies sin A will be equals to 4 by 5. If sin A is 4 by 5, what is cos A? You can substitute any of them. Any of these cases. So sin A is 4 by 5. So this will go that side and it will become cos A will be equals to 3 by 5. 7 by 5 minus 4 by 5. So in this particular case, we got this as the values. If I substitute here, so if I take sin A plus cos A, we already know that is 7 by 5. So what happened here? Sin will get cancelled and we will get 2 cos A will be equals to 8 by 5 and cos A will be equals to 4 by 5 here. If cos A is 4 by 5, sin A will be 3 by 5. Yes. So both of these are possible. Either this is possible, this is also possible. So if I take the first case, what am I supposed to find? 5 into sin A, 5 into sin A plus 10 into cos A. So 5 into sin A is how much here? 4 by 5 plus 10 into cos A is how much here? 3 by 5. That implies this is going to give us the answer as 4 plus 6, which is nothing but 10. If I substitute in this case, 5 into 3 by 5, sin is 3 by 5 here, plus 10 into cos is 4 by 5 here. So what do I get the answer here? 3 plus 8, which is nothing but 11 here. So both of them are possible answers for us. So either it can be 10 or it can be 11. So what is the answer for this question? Option A. X, Y and Z are real numbers such that X plus Y into X plus Y plus Z is equals to 120. Y plus Z into X plus Y plus Z is equals to 96. Z plus X into X plus Y plus Z is equals to 72. What is the maximum value of absolute value for X plus Y minus Z minus Z? Okay, so first let's try to identify what are the values of X, Y, Z. So if I take the values of x, y, z, so let me just consider this is equation 1. So this is equation 2, this is equation 3. So let me add all of them. If you carefully observe, if you add them, everywhere x plus y plus z is common. Right. So let me just take it out. So x plus y plus z is common. So what else is left in the first equation? X plus y is left. Plus second equation, what is left? Y plus z is left. And third equation, what is left? Z plus x is left. Right. So what I did, I just added all of them. So here what it will happen? 120 plus 96 plus 72 will come here, which is nothing but 288. Now, if you observe x plus y plus z here, and if you see here 2x, 2y, 2z. So can I say it as 2 into x plus y plus z will be equals to 288? That implies x plus y plus z whole square is going to be equal to 2 will come this side, right? Which is nothing but 144. That implies x plus y plus z is equals to 12. Yes. Actually, here it is not just 12, it is even minus 12 is also possible. You can take it as plus 12 or even minus 12 is also possible. Okay, minus 12 is also possible. Either plus 12 or minus 12 is also possible. Why? Because x, y, z can take the real values. So what do we do is we will identify what is values of x, y, z by using this plus value. So that in the last we can use minus, that will be the same thing. Okay, so first let's try to identify the x, y, z values by using 12. So what will happen for the first equation? X plus y will be equals to this particular value is 12. So this will go the sign 120 divided by 12, it will become which is 10. Yes, and then what do we get? Y plus z. Y plus z will be equals to 96. This will go that side. So 96 divided by 12, it will become which is 8. And here z plus x will be equals to 72 divided by 12, which is 6. This is a possibility. Or even x plus y is equals to minus 10, y plus z is equals to minus 8, and z plus x is equals to minus 6 is also a possibility. Okay, because x can here it can take either plus or minus 12, both are possible because they are real numbers. They did not give, they are positive numbers itself. Now, if I go through this one first, let me just consider these two equations. Let me just consider this is 1 and this is 2. Let me just solve them. So z and z will get cancelled here. So if I subtract it, if I subtract from this, I'll get y minus x will be equals to 2. We know x plus y is 10. And here we got y minus x is equals to 2. So let's solve them. So x plus y is equals to 10 and y minus x is equals to 2. So here this will get cancelled. So 2y will be equals to 12. That implies y is equals to 6. So if y is 6, what is value of x? X plus y is 10. So if y is 6, x is 4. Right? And similarly, y is 6. Y plus z is 8. That means z value will be 2. So according to this particular values, these are values of x, y, z. If you observe this one, okay, so let me just take first these two equations. I'll cancel z by using the subtraction here. So this will become addition. That means y minus x will be equals to minus 2 here, right? Because minus 8 plus 6. And similarly, x plus y is equals to minus 10, we know. So what happened now? Again, x will get cancelled. No need to change any operation. So 2y will be equals to minus 12. So y will be equals to minus 6 here. Yes, so if y is minus 6, what will be value of x? X will be minus 4. And similarly, z will be minus 2. That's why I said you, what you can do is you can just find out the positive roots and you can just add minus to them. That will automatically give the negative roots for you. So x is 4, z is 2 and y is 6. Here it will be minus 6, minus 4, minus 2. Both of these cases are possible. Now what is our question? We need to identify maximum value of this particular thing. Okay, so most of you will think maximum value will give for the positive ones. But actually that's not going to happen here. So what is this absolute value means? Even it is negative, you need to consider it as positive. That implies, for example, it is absolute value of minus 3. That means it is 3. We won't consider that as negative. So first, if I take this as positive value, so what do I get? X is 4 plus y is 6 minus z. Yes, minus z is again 2. So what is the value here? 8. This is already positive. So it will be taken as 8 itself. So 8 minus 2 is 6. But answer is not 6, because if you apply the negative values that you got, okay, so let us just apply the negative values. What is x minus 4? And what is y minus 6? And what is z minus of minus 2, right? And this is going to be again minus of minus 2, yes? So what happens here? Minus 10 plus 2, which is nothing but minus 8. And this is minus of minus will become plus 2. But this is absolute value. So how do we take it as 8 plus 2 is what we take. We don't take it as negative. So 8 plus 2 is what we take. That means 10 is the maximum value that this expression can take. Not 6, it's 10. So what is the answer for this question? It's option C. Most of you will take the positive things and go with the answer as 6. But that's not correct. The answer for this particular question is option C. So remember, the absolute value means we won't consider the negative one. We will just take the positive sign irrespective of the sign that you got here. It will be always positive. So the answer is option C. Circle having its center at point P and radius 1 centimeter has an arc XY which sustains an angle 60 degrees at point P. The area of region bounded by the radius XP, YP and the arc XY is denoted by A. M and N are the two points on XP and YP respectively, so that MP is equals to PN, and the area of the triangle PMN is equal to A divided by 4. What is the length of MP? Okay, so let's try to identify what the answer is. So first let's draw a circle. So the clearly said is the center of the circle is P. The center of the circle is P and the radius is 1 centimeter. So let's consider the center is P and radius is 1 centimeter, we know. And then the arc XY is there, which is going to make 60 degrees angle at P. That means let us consider the arc XY here. So this is the arc XY and here the angle will be 60 degrees. Okay, now... and this is going to make an angle of 60 degrees at P, nothing but the center. The area of the region bounded by the radius XP. What is XP? This is XP and YP. This is YP and the arc XY. That is nothing but this area they are speaking about. So this is nothing but the area of this sector. So what is that area will be nothing but when angle is known, theta divided by 360 degrees into pi r square. So that is the area of this sector, right? So let us just substitute theta, we know, which is 60 degrees divided by 360 degrees into pi into radius is 1 square. So this is going to give us pi by 6 as the area, which is pi by 6, and that is denoted by A here. That means value of A is equals to pi divided by 6. Next, M and N are the two points on XP and YP respectively. That means M will be here and N will be here. Okay, so that MP is equals to PN. MP is equals to PN. That means this both are same. If you just take at this particular triangle, if you take the look, the all sides of this triangle will be same, nothing but this and this is same. So if these are same, okay, if these are same, the opposite angles of them will also be same. They clearly said MP and PN are same. So if these are same, this both angles should also be same. Yes, so already we know this particular angle is 60 degrees. Total is 180 degrees in a triangle. So 180, already 60 is done. Yes, so 180, 60 is done means 120 degrees is left. And this both angles should be same. That means each will be 120 divided by 2, which is nothing but 60 degrees. That means this angle will also be 60 degrees. This angle will also be 60 degrees. So when the angles entire thing is 60, 60, that means what? That is going to form an equilateral triangle, isn't it? Now they clearly said as the area of the triangle, this particular triangle PMN is equals to A divided by 4. That means area of triangle PMN is equals to A divided by 4. We already know A value is pi by 6. That means pi by 6 divided by 4 is what they said. Yes. Now, we need to identify what is the area. So how do we identify the area? We already know that's an equilateral triangle. So what is the area of an equilateral triangle? Root 3 by 4 base square, which is nothing but MN whole square. Yes. So MN square. So this will be equals to pi by 6 into 1 by 4, it will comes to the top. So this and this 4 will get eliminated. So what do we get? Mn square will be equals to pi divided by 6 root 3. That implies value of Mn will be equals to root of pi divided by 6 root 3. Or we can even say it as pi divided by 6 root 3 whole to the power of 1 by 2. Right, because our options are in terms of 1 by 2. And what they ask us to identify, the length of MP. The length of MP is nothing but the length of MN also, because this is an equilateral triangle. That means all the sides will be same. So this will be the only answer, right? So this is nothing but value of MP also. So what is the length of this? It's nothing but option B here. Pi divided by 6 root 3 whole to the power of 1 by 2. Because MN will be equals to MP, because that's an equilateral triangle. So this both will be same. So answer for this question is option B. In a class, there are 10 girls. All girls are of different height. In how many ways can a team of 3 girls be selected out of these 10 girls, in which the first girl is always shorter in height than the second girl, and the second girl is always shorter in height than the third girl, and so on. So this particular question is actually very easy. They just tried to confuse you by giving this particular thing. See, if you observe, all girls are of different height. They clearly gave us all girls are of different height. And all you need to do is just select 3 girls of different heights. That's it. Total 10 girls are there. You need to select 3 girls. So that girls, anything might be girl 2 or girl 1 or girl 3. Whoever you select, definitely they will be of different height. So definitely compared to the one person, the other person will be taller because the height is different. Yes. So again, to the compared to that person, the other person will be again taller. So this is just to confuse you. So don't get confused. Out of 10, you just need to select 3 girls. That's it. So what is the answer? How do we select 10C3? So what will be the answer for this question? 10C3 is nothing but 10 into 8 into 9 divided by 1 into 2 into 3. Yeah, so let's just calculate. It will give us our answer. So how many ways we can do it? 120 ways we can do. So answer for this question is option B. So whoever you select, definitely the height of them will be different. That means compared to one person, the other person will be taller. Compared to the other person, the another person will be again taller. So the answer is 120. Thank you for watching the video till the end. If you like the video, do not forget to press the like button. And you can also join our social media platforms like Telegram group, Instagram page, and WhatsApp group. Link for all of this are in the description box. Thank you.